Yardist Imaginer, and it's time for another one. So, we're going to talk a little anime news again. Before we get into it, big shout out to Clownfish TV, because they actually gave me this idea, because they were talking about it, and I figured I should jump on this too, because I have an issue with what, basically, the, I guess you could still call them the mainstream, even though it's not really, but in general, how things that get popular always gets dogpiled by people who really don't understand it or don't care to understand it, or at the same time, they do understand it but want the clicks anyway. So we're talking about the Rising of the Shield Hero Season 2. Now, here's an anime that I didn't even know about, right? And then I heard the controversy, or should I say the non-troversy, that was surrounding this anime. So I decided to check it out myself. Yeah, I don't know what people are talking about, but this anime basically has the same anime formula as most of them, with the twist that it's almost like a RPG. It's like you're watching a anime version of a RPG going forward, where you have your tank, and then you have your DPS, your mage, all that stuff.
Let's look at
this article we have here from CBR, and it says, "Can the Rising of the Shield Hero Season 2 redeem the controversial anime?" And again, like I said, controversy is a big stretch of a word for something like this. But anyway, it says, "The Rising of the Shield Hero is infamous for being controversial, but its second season may have the potential to redeem it. It doesn't need redemption. It's a great anime." This is one of his article provides mentions of women abuse, slavery, and grooming, which is none of that in this thing. Absolutely none of it. Like, seriously. I mean, yeah, you could say the woman abuse portion of it. Yeah, it does have that implication in there. But it's not like they're showing anything. It's not like it's glorifying it in any way. And when they say the whole slavery thing, that's a bit of a stretch. And then let's be real. Let's be real, okay? Yes, slavery is bad, right? Slavery is very, very bad. But people tend to forget, you are actually a slave right now. If you don't own anything, right? I like to see you say, "I'm not going to go to work," or "I'm not going to pay my taxes." See what happens to you. You have a bit of a, for lack of a better term, an economic overseer above you. You, me, everybody. Everybody. Because I like to see anybody say, "I'm not going to pay taxes," or "I'm going to go to work," or "I'm not going to go to work, and I'm just going to do whatever." It's systems in place. So there's no real actual, yes, there's an amount of freedom out there, but economically speaking, we're all slaves. Every single one of us. If you have to get up every morning and go to work, you are a slave to this system. So let's not act like the whole, and I understand the modern day slavery that the North America has had was very vicious, very bad. We understand that. But this isn't that. Well, the way this thing works in there is that, and this is muscle memory because I haven't seen this anime in a bit of a minute. So the way it works is that in order for her to basically have to almost be like the same team. Like if you're in a party in a RPG, you have to be in the same party, whatever, you have to be in that party. So in order for them to be in the same party and their stats to raise up and go, you know, go up and down, they have to be connected in somehow. So they have this quote unquote slavery pact, which by the way, he doesn't use it in a vicious way. It's just a means for them to stick together, right? So they can level up together. So, in the world that it's in, it is not really a bad thing because I'm quite sure in all of the other teams, you have to kind of do the same thing in order for your team to level up. If you're going to have like your other teammates, if they're not on the same team as you, it's kind of weird. Because like I said, it's been a while since I've seen this. But I do know that it's basically a way for them to raise their stats up together in order for them to do this pact. And it's not really like, "Hey, you're working for me only." The girl that's in there wants to work for him. And then we're talking about the grooming situation where they're trying to say, oh, well, because she started out as a youngster, but they grow up differently. It's not like she was a child and stayed a child. Like, it's different. But that's beside the point. Okay, let's check out this article. It says, warning. Okay, we read that part. So, Rise of the Shield Hero has been steeped with controversy from the very beginning. Owning in a large part to how the main protagonist, Iwatani, is falsely accused of the R word, and is understandably how some viewers could be made to feel uncomfortable by Nafumi's relationship with his female companion, Raphtelia, as well as the origin of the infantilized personality. Oh yeah, over infantile, because she starts out young, but she grows up fast, right? They're different species. Yet the anime is pretty fans eager to upcoming season. Now let's look at the controversy as why this is, well, the second season has the potential to redeem it. So, so this is basically going over the same stuff we were talking about, right? What I was just saying. Now, I didn't even read this thing yet, but, so we don't have to go through all this. Basically, I basically covered what they were talking about anyway. So, in the end of the day, this is an controversy as far as this. And like I said, I honestly believe that this is just more of a reason for CBR to get clicks. Excuse me. And I'm looking forward to this. And by the way, let's be real, right? Once again, this falls in line with the whole concept of Western of sensibilities trying to be pushed on other cultures. In Japan, and again, this show is made by females, if I'm correct. The producer is a female. In Japan, their ways of entertainment and putting out anime and stuff like that is way different than what we do over here. And I really hate this whole concept that if things are this way over here, it's wrong everywhere else. You know what I'm saying? No. And I always will say this for the billionth time. Anybody in Japan who has any kind of power doing any of these animes, do not listen to these fools. Leave your stuff exactly the way it is. You have plenty of fans who enjoy the stuff how it is. And that's the biggest problem too, like I mentioned in one of my other videos. The fact that anime covers such a wide array of fan bases. Like I said, you have your Pokemons all the way up to freaking Shmentai, right? All that covers in anime that people don't, they just freaking throw a blanket statement that this is XYZ or this can't be for this or it can't be that. Listen, sure, there's some stuff that is not made for kids, which is why parents should parent. You should not make blanket statements for all of anime because this is for this is for that, and this is for this. You can't do that. If you're a parent and you don't want your kids to watch stuff like my parents did, watch their mom, but you would watch what your kids are watching. Know what they're watching. And don't sit there and go cry on the internet about stuff that you don't know about. Because this anime is really, it's so tame. Like, for instance, when you sit here and talk about the women abuse on this thing, right? You could make an argument about Goblin Slayer. Goblin Slayer, gangster. I don't recommend that for the faint of heart, okay? But I wouldn't want you to censor that either, because it shouldn't be. It shouldn't be censored at all. So, with that being said, this is super tame. Rise of the Shield Hero is so tame in comparison to things like Goblin Slayer and plenty of the other hardcore ecchi stuff that's out there. And even the Shmentai. The Shmentai is more gangster than all of that because that's show stuff. But again, that's not for kids. It always makes me think about what they're doing in Australia where they're banning stuff but then leaving cuties available. If you want to make an argument about bad stuff, cuties is a bad thing. Rise of the Shield Hero, even all the other stuff that I was mentioning, if it's for adults, it's for adults. If it's for kids, it's for kids. This, I'd say Rise of the Shield Hero was definitely teen plus, but again, it shouldn't be a big thing because it doesn't show anything, doesn't depict anything in a negative way. It's basically an RPG, like I said. That's basically what it is. But anyway, I've rambled enough. How do you feel about them yet again going after another anime because they don't understand or they do understand? Like I said, they understand what's going on here. This is basically awful. This has got to be. Now, the only problem is when it comes to the parents of these kids out there who want to go and make, and some of these legislators out there trying to make laws about that, y'all people are crazy. Y'all people are crazy because if you actually have power to make change, you're utilizing it against a freaking anime. That's a problem. But the CBRs of the world, you're doing it for clicks. We know that's what you're doing. We know it. We know. But anyway, how do you feel about that? Let me know in the comments. Like, share, subscribe, and of course, hit the notification bell so you can be visible and drop it. Remember, can't be good, you get at it. Manipulation, salvation. I heard that the best bet is monopoly. Ignorance, control, debt, from assets to pets. I stats defeated, and you never be satisfied.